It's a blackout.
And we know what that means. If anybody knows what that means, you know what it means.
You know that I do, believe me.
This man is a phenom.
Nothing will put fear in your heart like hearing this
news. He's scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Making his way to the ring from Denver.
Oh!
Weighing in at 328 pounds, the Undertaker.
This is a man that commands respect. He has earned the respect of each and every superstar that has ever competed in this business. He is the standard bearer here in the WWF, a genuine phenom, the Undertaker, and number one contender for Stone Cold's WWF title. Sean, you had to see last week when the Undertaker came out here posing as Kane. He won that triple threat match and then unmasked himself. You had to see the look on Stone Cold Steve Austin's face. What do you think was going through Stone Cold's mind when he realized that the Undertaker is now the number one contender?
I got news for you. You can be on top of the World Wrestling Federation. You can be the man like Stone Cold Steve Austin. But there is one guy that will forever be in the World Wrestling Federation. And put fear in your heart, and it is that man. He's always the number one contender if that's what he wants to be.
Last week, the Taker became the number one contender, and then it was signed just hours ago for SummerSlam. The Undertaker against Stone Cold. That is, if Stone Cold is still the WWF champion by August 30th.
I tell you what, JR, what the Undertaker did last week to me was just marvelous. One of the most intelligent things I've ever seen him do. A lot of people say he's sinister, say he's maniacal. What he was last week was downright smart.
Well, this is a great night, ladies and gentlemen. HBK is back. This is going to be a slobber knocker between The Undertaker and Vader. We've got that WWF tag title matchup still to come tonight. And let's not forget, gentlemen, that The Undertaker and Stone Cold are going to be partners. They've got to be partners. They've got to coexist when they meet Mankind and Kane 13 days from now at Fully Loaded.
Just like George Costanza says, world's colliding, world's colliding.
Wait, come on here. What is going on here? We may find out some answers right now, JR. Here it comes. Wow. The demonic Kane, and so much speculation. Were Kane and The Undertaker in cahoots last week? Were they in collusion? How did The Undertaker get Kane's wrestling attire?
I'll tell you what he did. He walked back there. He beat his little brother, will be honest, beat him to death. Stole his stuff. My brothers used to do it to me all the time. Beat me up, steal my clothes.
I don't know. I gotta think that possibly they are in cahoots. Well, they're brothers. Come on, let's face it. This match is scheduled to be The Undertaker one-on-one with Vader. But both Vader and The Undertaker have had huge problems with Kane. And what's he?
Oh, man. If it wasn't hot enough out here.
Whoa. And The Undertaker getting started here aggressively. The Undertaker has been in a vile mood in the last several weeks. And the Phenom is only stronger. Look at the elevation. Wow. Great athleticism there.
I guess that is the real Kane, you think?
I would assume so. Mankind's there. It's certainly the real Mankind and Paul Bearer.
And the fact that Mankind is there is a testament to Mankind, Mick Foley, whoever the hell he is this week.
Well, The Undertaker's got a lot on his mind. He's going to be Austin's tag team partner 13 days from now on pay-per-view at Fully Loaded. Undertaker will meet the WWF champion, whomever that may be, at SummerSlam. But this is a big man invader, Shawn Michaels, that you've defended the WWF title against this monster.
Well, I think one thing we're all going to find out is every guy that stepped in that ring has taken a thrashing or given a thrashing to the Heartbreak Kid. And you got two of the biggest and the strongest right here in the WWF.
Undertaker going for the cover now. And Vader able to kick out. Vader at 400 pounds has a lot to gain in this matchup against the number one contender.
That's right. The Undertaker be making a big mistake if he looks past Vader, thinking only about Fully Loaded.
Well, I'll tell you what Vince McMahon has done, and I don't know that he realizes it. He's been naming these guys week after week of who's the number one contender. And all it takes is one loss. If Vader upsets Taker, that makes him number one contender, doesn't it?
That's a very simple mathematics right there. The Undertaker cannot afford to look past anyone, and he will not. The Undertaker is focused as never before, in my view. People have said a lot of things about The Undertaker. that I don't believe to be true. But in any event, we'll get into that as the night progresses here. I just still don't know why Kane, Mankind, and Paul Bearer are edging closer to ringside here.
I'm going to tell you this, JR. I want an answer tonight, whether it's from you or whether it's from Undertaker and Kane themselves. I want to know if they're in cahoots. We need to find out tonight. Look, they're looking at each other right now.
The brothers, Kane and Undertaker.
I can tell it. I can tell from that look. They are in cahoots. They are united. They are a team. I can tell.
That's speculation, King. You're speculating. We don't know that. You may be right, but we don't know that conclusively.
The question I have is this. In cahoots, not in cahoots. Let's face it. Nowadays, in the WWF, the key is to get ahead. It doesn't matter how you do it. The key is to get ahead, by hook or by crook.
Vader with a modified power slam there on the Phenom. I'll tell you what. The world is talking about The Undertaker and Austin, how they will coexist at Fully Loaded against Kane and Mankind. And maybe that's what Kane and Mankind are down here to do, get a close look at The Undertaker. There's a cover. That may be all. Undertaker barely just got his right shoulder off the canvas.
Well, speaking of Mankind, you better keep your eye on him, because after what The Undertaker did to Mankind in that Hell in a Cell match, I can't believe that those two would have any kind of friendship or any kind of bond after the way they went at each other.
John, you watched the King of the Ring on pay-per-view there in San Antonio. What did you think when The Undertaker threw Mankind off the top of the cage?
Speechless. Speechless. I sat at home. I've never seen anything like that before in my life. I was so upset the next night on Raw, the next week on Raw. I didn't hear anything about it. And I'll tell you what, I'm going to go out and rent that video again. It is the most amazing thing you have ever seen. 20 feet down between one of these announce tables. And, folks, I'm telling you, just the fact that he's standing out there makes him one of the toughest men you will ever see.
And then what about the neck right after that? Undertaker took Mankind right to the top of the cage.
Whoa! Count here. Big splash.
And he choked
Undertaker
right to the cage.
Undertaker in trouble. There's a cover and a near fall. Oh, man, that was close. So close.
I don't want to say anything, but you don't hook a leg, you ain't going to beat him.
Vader just inches away from beating The Undertaker here.
Okay, what? Keep your eyes on Kane.
Kane and Mankind.
They're moving around.
Moving around out here.
Circling the wagons.
Oh, look at that. That's 400 pounds. Tombstone. Mankind's got a steel chair.
Look at Mankind.
The Tombstone. The Undertaker.
What is he doing?
He's got the three. And Mankind and Kane. Wait a minute. Oh. Kane is taking. Mankind was going to nail The Undertaker, but Kane took the chair away. From Mankind.
I told you I was right. I told you I was right.
Maybe Kane wanted to hit him. Kane nails Vader.
What?
Was Kane saving his brother, or did Kane want to do the honors?
Oh, come on.
Now I'm completely lost.
Don't be an idiot, JR. Kane and The Undertaker are thick as thieves. It's obvious to me.
Well, The Undertaker is still the number one contender. We've got more questions than we have answers here. Let's take another look. Folks, you be the judge here. Let's take another look at what just transpired moments ago. Mankind was going to nail The Undertaker with a chair and
without a doubt.
Took it away from him, but why?
Why? We want an answer, Sam.